boom, I was talking about how shit was popping in green. I forgot I left out a piece, like a mad important piece. Like, so boom, this is before niggas started all going over to the new side, when the nigga's son was like, everybody come to the new side so we could build this army, right? So we still on the old side at this time. So this nigga comes into jail, right? This nigga, I ain't even gonna mention son name, he comes into jail from the max. I mean, he a life ass nigga, and he got a reputation for getting extremely busy. So I don't know the nigga. So, you know, he an older nigga, and he already coming into jail influencing mad niggas. So in my head, I'm like, who is this nigga coming into jail influencing niggas? Like, he gets stupid busy and he's some type of leader nigga or something like that. I don't know the nigga from a can of paint. You understand what I'm saying? But niggas is telling me, nah, I was behind the wall with that nigga, son. That nigga gets stupid busy, son. You know what I mean? So I'm like, all right. So boom, I'm in the house. My other man comes in the house. This nigga named Great Mind. This is my son, I mean. Love him. But at the time, I ain't no son. So we both guard body. So, I mean, Great Mind comes in the dorm. He in there looking like he ready to take shit over. So I'm like, who is this nigga coming in the can, coming in here ready, like, looking like he trying to take shit over? You feel what I'm saying? So my son Great Mind from Queens and from Brooklyn, I think. Know what I mean? But son get busy. So, know what I mean? The nigga comes in the spot. You feel what I'm saying? He goes to the yard one day. We go to the yard. So we in the yard mad deep. This is before niggas went over to the new side. We in the yard mad deep. It's mad of us. It's like 20 of us, Brooklyn niggas, on the weekend. Like I said, it's the yard on the weekend is different from the yard during the weekday. On the weekend, that shit is dangerous, dangerous. Like, to a point where most niggas, if you wasn't tough, niggas don't even come to the yard on the weekend at all. You understand what I'm saying? Because it be fucking jumping. You hear me? Every gang, especially on the old side of green, is small. So niggas got us smacked in, like, to the size of like 2-3 handball courts was the size of the entire yard. So they got 8 different active gangs and shit like that inside a little ass yard where niggas barely got space to even walk. You feel what I'm saying? So we in there, it's like 20 of us. Know what I mean? We all standing over there where the Brooklyn niggas stand at. Latin Kings, Yetas, them niggas on handball court, whatever, whatever. So the dude, the lifer nigga who came into jail, that was an older nigga, he's spinning the yard with the kid Great Mind, who just came to my dorm that I didn't know yet. So I'm looking at these niggas spinning the yard. I'm like, these niggas in here about to start some shit. You feel what I'm saying? And I hope if this nigga coming in here to start all of this shit, I hope he get busy like niggas say he get busy. The life of nigga, right? So, like I said, Great Mind and the life of nigga is spinning the yard, talking to politics about what they gonna do with this race war situation. You feel what I'm saying? Word to everything I love. Out of nowhere, while these niggas spinning the yard, one of these Latin gangs sent the doja. The nigga tries to run up on the life of nigga with an ice pick and stab the life of nigga with the ice pick. This is on my soul, nigga. This nigga grabbed the motherfucking banger in midair, flipped it out his hand, took the banger, put it in his pocket, and pushed this nigga like, get the fuck out of here. So the nigga like, I'm like, hold up. I said, did that nigga just take his banger and push this nigga like a little kid? Like, get out of here, shorty. I was like, oh shit. Now I done heard rumors in the jails and the maxes. I've been in a couple of maxes, but I never was there for a long period of time, only a few months. You feel me? So I'm like, niggas used to tell me, oh, niggas in the maxes, my nigga. Them niggas be flipping they bangers, having strings attached to that shit so it can't fall off their arm. They be going in. So I think that shit was, you know, folklore on how niggas get busy with bangers. My nigga, this nigga ran up on us. All this shit looked like it happened in slow motion, but it didn't happen in slow motion. This nigga ran up on this nigga and tried to plunge the ice pick into the nigga's stomach, my nigga. This nigga talking to another nigga walking. Nigga just was like, give me this shit. Boy, get the fuck out of here. Push the nigga. Nigga just was like this, and the nigga kept moving. So once that happened, the police didn't see it, but they know something happened because every race just went with their own race. Once that shit happened, all the blacks went to the blacks, all the Spanish niggas went to the Spanish niggas, the Muslims went to the Muslim niggas. You feel what I'm saying? Everybody went to their own group. So the police saw that shit. They was like, nah, something happened. They pulled the pin. Boom. On the go back. You feel what I'm saying? So they start telling niggas, yo, that niggas gotta go. That niggas gotta go. So I'm like, oh shit. You understand what I'm saying? This nigga just disarmed this nigga, took his banger, and now it's on because they tried to hit the nigga. So now he know niggas got a hit out on him. So now he gonna put in that work. Or I ain't know if he was gonna put in that work. So I'm like, oh, so we go back to the dorm. Now it's tension in the dorm. Crazy because of what happened in the yard between the blacks and the Spanish niggas. So now nobody can't sleep in the dorm, my nigga. That night, nobody could go to sleep. Like I said, me and my son used to have to take turns sleeping, watching each other. Because if I'm asleep, we sleep. One of them Spanish niggas could just run in our motherfucking dorm and pop off because we black. You understand what I'm saying? So we had to take turns sleeping that night, watching each other because of this nigga who got disarmed. So now the jail talking like, yo, this nigga gonna put in work. This nigga get stupid busy. He gonna put in work. So I'm like, we'll see. You feel what I'm saying? So the next day, matter of fact, yeah, the next day, that night, the next night, right? Real talk, my nigga. We coming out for chow, right? We coming out for chow. F dorm and G dorm. My nigga Crime, my nigga Glock, them niggas is coming out. My nigga Marvell, I think Marvell was there. You know what I mean? We walking to chow. So it's dark, my nigga. Green is dangerous. They be having niggas walking on walkways. That shit be dark. No light, so a nigga could just stab you up, get away with it, and I mean all of that, right? So, so we walking, so we coming out. As soon as I come out the dorm, I see some commotion. Like, I see some commotion a little bit ahead of me in the dark. You feel what I'm saying? So I ain't paying it no mind, a little bit of commotion. So I kept it moving. You understand what I'm saying? So I'm walking. So the nigga Crime and the nigga Glock, they walking behind us. So I see them niggas stop. And they turn around. So the nigga Glock is like, yo, come on, son. Come on, mind your business, son. Mind your business. You ain't got nothing to do with that. You feel me? So the nigga Crime like, nah, son, I want to see that shit. So boom, the kid that they, the life of nigga who they tried to stab, that he disarmed him. It was a Spanish nigga in his house. You feel what I'm saying? I don't know if he was involved with a gang or what. You know what I mean? But the life of nigga, he wanted to get up out of there because he knew it was a hit out on him. So he had some other nigga with him. You understand what I'm saying? And bro, they ran up on the Spanish nigga, my nigga, and they start stabbing the nigga up right in front of the police. The police sitting in the bubble, like a heated little shack for them to watch, you know, the chow run. Son, they start stabbing this nigga up in front of the police. Bing, 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 cutting the nigga. One nigga is cutting the nigga, the other nigga is stabbing the nigga, right? Yo, bro, so like I said, my nigga Crime and Glock, they looking, they like, oh shit, they eating that nigga food, son. You feel what I'm saying? So, real talk, my nigga, the life of nigga, he just drops his weapon. Them niggas just drop their weapons on the floor like, fuck out of here, nigga. Get me the fuck out of here. You understand what I'm saying? And them niggas bounced. They walked away. The police was so scared. The police jumped out. He didn't even pull a pin. He's supposed to pull a pin when something like that happened. He jumps out. He like, yo, don't move. I'm going to get you to a hospital. Don't worry. I'm going to get you to the hospital. Niggas cut this nigga from here through his cheek, over through the next cheek, to whereas all of this was one mouth, my nigga. His shit was flapping. His cheeks was split open on both sides, and his shit was flapping like a giant mouth. Niggas blew his whole mouth open with a rug cutter. Son, the nigga standing there, he just don't even want to move. He like, so much blood is squirting out of his face and his sides from getting stabbed up. The police ain't even pull a pin. He was like, I'm going to get you to the hospital. Come on, come with me, come with me. He trying to walk with this nigga to the hospital, my nigga. I'm like, oh, shit. That nigga whole face was a mouth, my nigga. It ain't even funny. I never seen no shit like that. I was like, whoa. So like I said, I was underestimating the life of nigga. Like, this nigga better get busy. Like, he say he getting busy coming in here starting problems and wars. He did get busy, my nigga. Because they tore that nigga the fuck up crazy. You understand what I'm saying? And I never seen a cut that bad. And I've seen some terrible fucking cuts up north in Rikers Island. But I never saw a nigga's shit that bad, my nigga. That niggas gave that nigga a giant mouth, my nigga. It was ugly.